So if you'd like to take a seat just a bit for me. Thank you.
Test group B3. We are still setting up the experiment. The presentation will begin shortly. We just need optimal conditions before we begin. We appreciate your patience, and your contributions to science will be noted.
Thank you for volunteering.
Thank you.
Ding, ding, ding. Can employee 73 report to the manager's office? That's employee 73 to report to the manager's office.
Hello.
Hi.
Nice to see you, sir.
Would you like a
cranberry
juice?
No.
Take a seat.
Yes. There isn't a seat.
Take a seat.
Okay. So, we appear to have had some problems from your machine.
Problems?
Nightmares.
That's impossible, sir.
Dreams are supposed to be wonderful and happy experiences. At this factory, there is no room for error. We cannot afford for you to be slipping nightmares from your machine. I have one here. Would you like to hear it?
No, I don't think I
should. No, I think it'd be a good idea. I think I should recite what errors to you. Really, I think you ought to hear it.
Okay.
It is very dark. I tiptoe through the forest, the leaves rustling around my cold feet. It is very cold. I hear his snarls. They come from all around me. Every turn I make, trees close in around me. The gnarled fingers of their branches reach out and scratch and claw at my face. And I begin to run. There's no escape now. I'm going in circles. I want to get out. He's getting closer to me now. I feel my skin shake and shiver around my rattling bones. I see him. He's coming. And I wake up. Well, great shit. Anything to say?
Well, I mean, what's wrong with that? I mean, there's a bit of excitement and there's a bit of a thrill when he wakes up. I'm very happy.
There's nothing fun about that. Look, we can't afford for these mistakes to be happening. We have to let you go.
Okay, alright, that one might have been a bad dream, but okay. I've had plenty of good work over my time here. Yeah, okay, what about my love range? Okay, so, making love in the moonlight.
You said that to a four-year-old.
Running through a meadow with your lover.
You sent that to a widow with hay fever.
Okay, forget about that. What about a classic of mine, okay? Yeah, this can't be beat. Riding in a banana split boat down a chocolate river towards Candyland.
You sent that to a diabetic. Look, I appreciate your earlier work and everything you've done here, but we have to let you go.
I've worked here for 43 years. You can't just get rid of me now.
Well, I'm truly sorry you didn't make it to 44.
Hello, sir. How are you doing today?
I'm fine, thank you.
Good. Nice to see you. Take a seat.
Would either of you care for a cranberry juice?
I believe we'll take three of your partners.
I'm so sorry.
Yes. Okay, so you two are looking to become parents.
Yes. Right, yeah.
Yes, and you've gone for the surrogate route. Thank you very much. We can just, if we get up the surrogate list, we have a...
We've already got a surrogate.
Oh, perfect. If you just send me their details, I can get them into the system, and we can get moving straight away.
I'm just going to go upstairs and get the chance.
Okay.
Sure.
So, as I said, we can get going straight away. a bit of a delicate matter to talk about. Which of you is to... become the biological parent?
For medical reasons, it's going to be me.
Fantastic. Well, we'll get going straight away then.
Yeah.
Are you okay, sir?
That's good. What I think I'm going to do is go and not hit, because then that would make you...
That would make me do what? Obviously I have to block you, so I have to go there, but the game is not yet
up. Oh yeah, well it's just...
How would you then play this one?
Oh well, obviously you stopped me there, so if I then just go here, the obvious move for you, so then go is there, isn't it?
Hi. It's me.
Hi, Dad.
That was very clever.
What are you doing?
I'm playing noughts and crosses with my friend.
What friend?
He came back.
No, please. He can't be back. All the work we did after your... Well, it's been a long time since your mum left. You can't bring him back again.
I get lonely here. I get lonely, and then he's there. Why can't you see him?
Look, come here. It's just you and me in this room. There's no one else here. Can't you see that? Can't you see that it's just you and me now? I know it's difficult, but...
Yeah.
Look, I don't think I can do this anymore, son.
No.
I can't be around you when you're like this.
Leave me again. Don't leave me. Can I come with you?
It's time for food.
It's your go.
No, honestly, I think it's a really good thing for us to do. We've known each other for so long, and letting bring us closer as friends.
I don't want you to feel like you have to carry on with it. You know, if you change your mind and then, you know, feel duty to me, I don't want you to have to go through,
no, I just
that.
With all we've got in this age of science and technology and safety, I just don't think, when you consider the risks, there's really that much of a problem. I just think that it's something that is, it'll be easy. It's, excuse me. You can't just move us around like that. We're trying to have a conversation.
Sorry, I was just setting up for the next bit.
Just keep yourself, okay?
Sorry.
Do you still be leaving love?
long time since my wife left us. It's not even the same since, you know. As soon as they could, my boys left the house, and ever since I've been redecorating and redecorating and hoping that, I don't know, hoping it'd be different, but it's not. It's the same stuff, and I just don't know what to do with myself anymore.
Suppose I'm miserable, really. I wake up miserable, I eat my breakfast miserable, get ready miserable, catch the train miserable, but the only time I'm really finding happiness is when I'm playing in front of the people. It reminds me of how things used to be.
So, Why My Family Died is a collection of anonymous tales. I mean, it's rubbish. They're all rubbish. But if I don't do it, then it's all I've got is just like a grey office, day after day.
I'm the one who made it. I'm the one with all the money. That doesn't make me happy. It doesn't make anyone happy. They don't have the best jobs, but they go home every single night to their wives and their girlfriends who love them. I mean, Yvonne's nice now, but she's not here for my good looks and she has an expensive taste.
I sit there every day, stare at the music and hope something good will come from it. But the worst thing is my eldest brother actually thinks we're all happy. Couldn't be further from the truth. Did try to call Dad, actually. If someone had fixed the phone in the bloody lobby.
I got divorced 3 months ago. I didn't tell any of them. They don't know if they care. My dad called about a month ago. Didn't know I had an answer. I asked my brother for a job about 4 months ago. He said no. He said I didn't have the charisma.
I envy them. I really do, because I'm wealthy physically, they're wealthy emotionally, they're with their friends and family and just love. All the stress of the workload I have, I get these migraines, these headaches. My brother asked for a job, I said no, he wouldn't like the lifestyle, it would make him miserable too. Even when I phone my dad, just shouts at me as though no one calls him anymore. I've given up. You know, sodom. They can be happy on their own.
None of us are successful. Well, no. My oldest is successful, but he's miserable. More miserable than the rest of us, and we're not particularly happy. We live in the shells of men that we could have been, in the shadow of lives that we could have lived in, and it's not enough anymore. They don't even like the taste of whiskey anymore. And then I think it tastes more like cranberry juice. It's abysmal. When my wife left, she ruined this family. I just wish one of them would pick up the phone and call me.
Thank you.
How long does labour even take?
I don't know, it's probably about an hour.
Hour? Well, is that all?
There's a lot of pushes.
Are you sure we made the right choice?
How do we?
Medically.
How?
We chose you medically because, you know. Why did we choose her?
Well, because we're friends.
No,
we know her.
Your friend.
Oh, come on.
I think she's a bit fat. What? You heard me. I think she's a bit fat.
Hello. Sorry, I'm late.
It's doctor.
Look, there's been a complication.
Sorry?
You see, her respiratory system shut down, and as did the cardiovascular, and before we knew it, the infection had spread everywhere. I'm sorry. Yes, I'm sorry. Look, I'm going to go upstairs and sort out the paperwork, and I'll send someone down for you. I'm
sorry.
Hey.
Hey.
What time did you get off tonight?
8:00.
8:00, then. Huh? Pick you up at 9, yeah?
Sure thing. See you later.
Wear something nice.
Will do.
Paperwork. Is that all we're up to? Just paperwork?
Why? Where the coat?
This is all your fault.
This what?
She's your friend, not mine. You're the one who suggested her and forced her upon us.
No, I didn't know.
She stopped breathing. You heard it. She was in fact. She was too fat. She was too fat. She was too.
Do you know how long labour it takes?
About a day, isn't it?
A whole day.
That means a lot of pushing.
Are you sure we made the right choice?
About what?
Medically.
How do you mean?
We chose you medically. You know why. Why did we choose her?
Because we know her, because we're all friends with her.
No. You know her. I think she's too fat.
Oh, what?
Hello.
She's too fat.
Look, there's been a complication. I'm sorry, her respiratory system shut down before long, so did her cardiovascular, and then the infection spread to the rest of the body, and neither of them made it. I'm sorry. There was nothing we could have done. We tried everything. Every medical thing we could have done. I don't know. It just didn't happen. I'm sorry.
They're both dead.
Yes, I'm sorry. I'm gonna go upstairs and sort out the paperwork. I'll send someone down.
Hey, babe.
Hey, what time do you finish?
About 73.
I'll pick you up at 17.
Okay, babe.
Wear something sexy.
Will do.
This is all your fault! You heard the man. She stopped breathing.
Yeah, that's nothing.
She stopped breathing and you suggested her. Why did you suggest her?
Because we know she's gonna be friends with her.
No! You're friends with her, not me!
She wasn't that too bad.
Sorry, do you know how long labour normally takes?
About a year, isn't it?
It's a long time, but
I suppose...
It's got a crawl, a very long one. Why did we choose her?
How do you mean?
Why?
You know, we're friends with her.
No, we're not. You're friends with her. No.
You agreed.
She's too fat.
She is.
She's not
too
fat.
That wasn't
no,
that.
She's fat.
Not with her.
It's been a complication, okay? Look, I'm sorry. It's not working out. I'm sorry.
Are you breaking up with me?
Look, it's not my fault. There's been problems at work. I'm so stressed. I can't. There was this woman. She went into respiratory failure. Her cardiovascular system, it shut down. She's dead. Okay, she's dead.
No,
I don't know what to do.
Oh my God.
We know this, don't we? She was too fat. Stop this!
Need another round?
Yeah, go on.
Yeah?
Yeah, cheers.
Cool.
Look, the only way we're going to win is if we play basic football. We're not going to be able to do anything in an advanced formation because we've got no creative players. Can't you see that? It's basic level football. If we can't pass, why are we playing with a deep line four? It just doesn't make sense. We need to play a 4-4-2. It's the only way we're going to do the basics right.
Sorry,
see?
I don't mean to interrupt, but do you suggest that we do a 4-4-2?
Yes.
You know the days of that are long gone.
No,
that doesn't work.
4-4-2 still works so long as you've got the right players for it. We've got the right players for it. We can't play in those advanced formations.
Right, unfortunately, the modern game does not allow for one defensive midfielder. You have to have those two deep
lines. No, but that's the point, though.
Because you can't play. There's too much attacking flair in the modern game.
Don't you understand?
You cannot play with no defensive midfielders. You have to have them in the game. Stop running away from me. You have to have the defensive midfielders in the game. 4-2-3-1 is the only way.
It's all this shit. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight you have been part of a selected test group aimed at aiding the scientific research into the human condition. Thank you for your time and your contribution to science. You'll find a full write-up of our reports, which we hope you have found as enlightening as we have, at human.com. In the name of science, we thank you.
So what if we double the dose for the third section?
That's what I'm thinking. If we double it and maybe release more into the general environment, I think that would work pretty well.
What about their response?
Yeah, so I think their response was pretty much on the books.
Experiment 3 was off the charts.
Experiment 3 was inside the stand.
Close the doors.
Close the doors.